You've made a YouTube banner using Canva and have uploaded it. And you're thinking to yourself, why are they giving me such large dimensions when I can only see a very small part of it? Not only are you gonna learn how to find your safe zone for your YouTube banner, I'm gonna share with you why your YouTube banner is like cake. Yes, I said cake. Let's go to Canva and open up a YouTube banner. You're gonna go to search your content and Canvas and type in YouTube banner. Your options are probably going to look different than mine because I do have a lot of stuff in my account for YouTube banners, but we're just going to click this one, search for YouTube banner. We're going to scroll down for Canva templates and click create a blank YouTube banner. This banner right here is sized 2560 wide by 1440 tall. You need to take into consideration the way people are going to view your content. Some people watch YouTube channels on phones. Some people watch it on a computer. Some people watch it on tablets, and some people even watch it on television. You need to design your YouTube banner so that it will work with all of the different devices. Also, you need to make sure that the most important part of your YouTube banner is in a very small segment right in the center and middle of this huge design. We'll get to why we need such a big design in a little bit, but the safe zone for your document is actually 1546 pixels by 423 pixels. But don't just make the mistake of opening up a new Canva document and sizing it to be 1546 by 423, because all that's going to do is, first, YouTube's not going to accept it because that dimension is actually too small. Even if it did upload, it still wouldn't look right on all devices. Let me show you how to find your safe zone within this canvas. Type R on your keyboard. If you're not on your computer, you can actually go to the Elements tab and search for shapes. Find a square there too. Click on your square, go to Position. Make sure that you are on the Arrange tab and scroll down. Under this advanced section right here, we're going to click on Width and type in 1546. And then for height, we're going to change this to 423. Move up to the Align to Page segment. Move this to the center and middle of your design. This is actually the safe zone for all areas. Now we're going to type L on the keyboard. L, and go here right above the rectangle, and we're going to drag this line across. And then all we need to do is click this little duplicate button and drag it down here. Pretty much this whole middle section that you see is what you can see on desktop. There is a small subsection of viewers that watch on tablet, and it's going to be somewhere, and maybe let's just bring this out a little bit. Like, it's going to be something like that that they see, but know that if you design for the middle and center in this area, it will take care of those tablet users as well. Your TV audience, when they go to your homepage, they basically are going to see this full thing. Although somewhere about here is where some of the YouTube UI might get in the way on your television. But, you know, when you're designing, essentially just focus on that middle part, even if some of it gets cut off on TV. Here is my YouTube banner. I was very intentional with what the background of my YouTube banner looked like. Here, I've added my community Canvassador logo for 2025 with the words Canva for YouTube and Creator Strategies, because that's essentially what you get on this channel. I was very strategic in placing that information in the middle and center of this YouTube banner. I created this little template where I can check how my banner is going to look on desktop. And then I have another template that will check to see how it looks on mobile devices. I also know that my whole design looks nice. Those of you that are in my newsletter crew on the Friday after this is released will get two templates. The first template is what you'll see on mobile device, and it's going to look like something like this, except for it's going to have a clear background. You can upload this into your Canva account and check your YouTube banners. By the way, just click on uploads, upload file. The other one will look like this, and you can do the same thing. If you are not on the email list, or if you're watching this later and have not received these two templates to be able to look to see whether you can see it on phone and computer, I'm going to drop a link for you to be able to get that straight into your email. That is going to be linked in the description box below. You might still be wondering, why do they give you such large dimensions when you only see a small part of it? Imagine you're baking a huge birthday cake. Everyone can see the full design, but when guests step closer to the cake, they can only see a portion of that cake. Guests want to eat that cake. This slice of cake is a small representation of the full cake. In order for your guests to receive a slice of the cake, you must bake the whole cake. It's important for your YouTube banner to be 2560 by 1440 pixels in order for those that are viewing it on mobile device to see that slice of banner. Knowing your save zone is only part of the battle. You need to know how to design within that safe zone. Watch us next to learn more about YouTube banners, and I'll see you over there. Bye.